Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Thank you. Christ, God, Lord, our Lord, raise my sick to the position of life, and into the fountain of mercy, bind to the light of eternal brightness, for thee, to the Lord of heaven and earth. I'm glory for thee, abundance of God, receive the mercy of the gallows, thou sent heal my sickness, to wash me my thoughts, to wipe my thoughts, to remove my poverty, to remove my nakedness, and to receive the great name of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, with such reverence and humility, with such intuition and devotion, such purity and faith, such purpose and intention as is profitable for the salvation of my soul. Grant, I beseech thee, that I may not only receive the sacrament of the body and blood of our Lord, but also the effect of the power of the sacrament. O most gracious God, let us receive the body and blood of the Son of Jesus Christ, our Lord, which is to let the Virgin Mary, that I may be worthy to be open to his mystical body and number among these men. So must love the Father, grant me the now purpose of my privilege to receive beneath the veil eyes of the Son, to be open the veil face to face forever, who live in the rays of the unity of the Holy Ghost, God, through all ages, world, without end. Amen. O Mother, pity and mercy, most blessed Virgin Mary, God, is the unworthy sinner, be unto thee with all my heart, with all my affection. I beseech that the mercy that thou hast in thy world, with the Son, who hung upon the cross, so that was gracious thou sit to stand by me as a sinner in all our peace. For we are not that only church, this day we offer. That by the help of God's grace, we may be able to offer the sacrament of the most high, and provide truly a worthy and acceptable oblation. Amen. O blessed Saint Joseph, happy among men, that it is given unto thee, not only to see and hear. The God of many kings desire to see us, all not to hear, but not to. But also to carry the grace of the world and protect him. Pray for us, O blessed Joseph, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray, O God, to give to us royal graces, thou say we pray thee, that like his blessed Joseph was found worthy of heaven to hold the carriage on that we got sent one with the Mary. So God wants to get us in purity and politics to be his sort of God of the altars. That we may this day worthy to seek the sacred body and blood of Christ in the world to come. We found worthy to retain the word of eternal life and save Christ, by the way. Angels, archangels, angels, all the nations, principles, powers, and virgins of heaven, cherubim, seraphim, all these saints of God, especially our patrons, St. Alphonsus, Maria de Guari, St. John Moon, and St. Padre Pio, thou say to receive from me that I may be enabled worthily to offer this sacrifice to Almighty God, to the praise and the glory of his name, for my benefit and that of this holy church. O holy St. Barnabas, behold, I am a miserable sinner, trusting in thy mercy, to offer now the most holy sacrament of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For thy honor and glory, I pray thee humbly to God, and thou wouldst thou save this day to intercede for me, that I may be enabled worthily to accept his office and greatest sacrifice, that with thee and all his elect heavenly praise and eternally and reign with him, who livest and reigns world without end. I desire to celebrate the holy sacrifice of the Mass, to consecrate the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to the rites of the Holy Catholic Church, in praise of Almighty God, the whole church, triumph through the benefit of myself, the whole church, and militant, who have commended themselves to my prayers in general and in particular. We pray for all of the parishioners, the saints, teachers, and all traditional Catholics, for our society, the St. Alphonsus Maria de Guari, the Bishop Ben Jackson, the Bishop David Eddy, the Bishop David McCool, all of our priests, our religious brothers and sisters here in the United States and throughout the world, for our religious community, for the good estate of the Holy Catholic Church, for all faithful. The Almighty, merciful Lord, grant to In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, amen. Et in vivo ad eterni Dei. You can make days to each and every house, and may the gentleman's santa above the end of the doors that are being made.
We have first day, which was so bad, or at least three quarters, the chest, to not be given in
there. And we can use to a very tough and to easy that it looks like that it looks like 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 it looks like
it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks
like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks
like it looks like it looks like it looks like it looks
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicura nat principio et semper, et saecula saeculorum. Amen.
In true people, ad eterni Dei.
Ad deum fidificatium institutum Dei.
Agitorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Refreci caelum et
terra. Ad filia Deorum potenti, beata Maria, sede Virgini, beata Michele, et patro Tiole Baptiste, sanctus apostolus spiritus, paulus sanctus et tibi fratres. In the Domini Viscotitas, in the Verbe de Tor. Deus, in the presence of the vocalis, was austerity of the service of the Corinthian Tua, Domine Xavier Batsman, and the man, and Domine Spokis,
and
all the
Oh.
Father,
Dominus Dominis cum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sequentia sancti, inventeres et unum.
Gloria tibi Domine.
Church of Saints Peter and Paul, the Mother House Church of our community, the Society of St. Alphonsus Marie de Liguori. To all of our visitors who are here with us today, we welcome you to the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass on this second Sunday after Pentecost and the Octave of Corpus Christi. We also like to pray continually for our Deacon Cyril Forster and his loss, that God will give him grace and peace. And to all of you that are born this month in June, we want to say happy birthday to all of you. A certain man made a great supper. From the Gospel of St. Luke, being the third of the Gospels of the New Testament, chapter 14, verse 16. A certain man made a great supper. In the Gospel of this day, we read that a rich man prepared a great supper. He then ordered one of his servants to invite to it all those who might find themselves outside of the great supper, to invite all those whom he might find in the highways, the byways, even though they were poor, blind, and lame. And he asked the servant to compel those who should refuse to come to the supper. In verse 20 of St. Luke 14, he says, "Go out into the highways and the hedges and compel them to come in, that they may fill my house." And he added that all of those who had been invited and had not come, not one should ever partake of this great supper. In verse 24 of St. Luke 14, it says, "But I say unto you that none of those men that were invited shall taste of my supper." This supper, my sons and daughters, is the Holy Communion. It is the great supper at which all of God's people, all of the faithful, all of the baptized into the mystical body of Christ are invited to eat the sacred flesh of Jesus Christ in the most holy sacrament of the altar. In the Bible, in the Gospel of Matthew chapter 24, verse 26, it says, "Take ye and eat. This is my body." Let us, for a few moments, consider today, in the first point, the great love with which Jesus Christ has shown us in giving us himself in the Holy Mass, in the sacrament of the altar. The first point is on the great love which Jesus Christ has shown each and every one of us in showing himself to us, in coming to us in Holy Communion, in this sacrament. In the Gospel of St. John, chapter 13, verse 1, it says, "Jesus knoweth that his hour has come, that he should pass out of this world to the Father, having loved his own that were in the world, he loved them unto the end." Knowing that the hour of his death had arrived, Jesus Christ wished, before his departure from this world, to leave each and every one of us the greatest proof,
which he could give us of his love by leaving us himself, by giving himself to us in the Holy Eucharist. This is the greatest gift, the holy sacrifice of the Mass. Christ has left us himself. You want to know him? Receive him in Holy Communion. The precious body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus Christ. This is according to St. John Chrysostom, whose relic we have on this altar. He speaks of the extreme love. This was God's love for us. It was extreme. He loved us so much that he left us the Holy Communion. St. Bernardine of Siena says that the tokens of love which are given at death make a more lasting impression on the mind and are more highly esteemed. But whilst others leave so many things in their lives when they die, they leave a ring, they leave money as a mark of their affection for their loved ones. But no one has left us something so great than Jesus himself. You see, when you have him, you don't need anyone else. When you have him, you don't need anything else. When you truly have him, you have everything you need. You see, the things of this world pass. They are here today. They are gone today. We have our cars, our homes, our jobs. They are here today and gone today. But when we have Jesus, we have everything. And when did Jesus Christ institute this sacrament of his love? He instituted the sacrament of his love when he was sitting with his disciples at the Last Supper. He instituted it, as the apostles had remarked, on the night before he died. The Lord Jesus Christ, the same night on which he was betrayed by Judas Iscariot for 30 pieces of silver, the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 11, 23-24, he took bread. He gave thanks. He broke that bread and said, "Take ye and eat. This is my body." And so at the very same time that men were preparing to put our Lord to death, our loving Savior, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, resolved to bestow upon each and every one of us the greatest gift of his love. Jesus Christ then, he was not content with giving his life for us on the cross of Calvary. He wished also, before his death, to pour out, as the Council of Trent says, all the riches of his love by leaving himself for our food in Holy Communion. He, as it were, poured out the riches of his love towards us. And so, if faith had not taught it, who could ever imagine that a God would become human, a God would become man, a God would become flesh? St. Paul says in Galatians 4, he was made of a woman, born under the law for our sakes. For our sakes and for our salvation. Yes, he came down from heaven and was incarnate in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary and became man for us. Yes, Jesus Christ is truly man and truly God. He has two natures, human and divine. When Jesus Christ revealed to his followers this sacrament which he intended to leave us, St. John says in John 6:53-61 that they could not bring themselves to believe it and departed from him, saying, they couldn't understand when he said, take and eat. They were not practicing cannibalism. Take and eat your flesh. How can he give us his flesh? And the Lord said, he that eats this bread and drinks this cup shall have life in them, and I will raise them up in the last day. They questioned, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? This saying is hard for us. Who can hear it? And so many of you probably think this is still hard. When we come to the altar to receive communion, we no longer receive bread. It looks like bread, it smells like bread, but it is Christ. For something happens at this altar, the miracle of the transubstantiation. Christ comes down upon this altar when the words of institution are pronounced over the bread and the wine. This is my body, this is my blood, and that's exactly what he meant. And we no longer receive bread and wine, but we receive Jesus Christ, our Savior. How highly honored each and every one of us ought to be to know that our Savior loved us so much. We are honored by his presence in the Blessed Sacrament. In the Holy Communion, Jesus Christ, our Savior, and you ought to rejoice in this, because this is your strength. Holy Communion is your food for the journey. He said, I give you this, and do this until I come again. You want to be strong? You want to be healed and delivered? Receive the Holy Communion often. Do not miss Mass if you can. Give Christ your heart, because he gives us his heart. In Holy Communion, Jesus gives us not a part of his arm, but his entire body in the sacrament of the altar. He gave you all, says St. John Chrysostom. Reproving our ingratitude, he left nothing for himself. And St. Thomas Aquinas, the great theologian, the Dominican, the eloquent teacher, the angelic doctor teaches that in the Eucharist, God has given us all that he is and all that he has. And communion is all you and I need. Because communion wraps up the whole Bible. Because the Eucharist sums it all up from the Old Testament to the New Testament. He said, take and eat this in commemoration of me. For this is my body, this is my blood of the new covenant, the New Testament. So, even if you've never read the Bible or if you don't even read it, just know by faith, you believe that Christ is with you when you receive Holy Communion. And listen, if you come to the altar in that faith, when you receive his precious body and blood, soul, and divinity, whatever you may be going through, casting all your care upon him at the altar, when you receive him, he becomes that living bread that heals our souls physically, spiritually. He is the antidote. He is the medicine for our souls. I love the Holy Mass. I praise God that he has ordained me a priest, consecrated me a bishop. I praise God that I can stand at the holy altar and offer the holy sacrifice of the Mass each day for the living and for the dead. And be sure that every day your names are called out before God, before the altar. And beneath that altar are the names of all of you, laying there as I'm offering the Mass sacramentum caritatis, dignus caritatis. A sacrament of love. A pledge of love. Remember that. A sacrament of love. A pledge of love. And so it is in this sacrament of love, because it was pure love that induced Jesus Christ, our Savior, to give us his gift and his love. For he wished that you should believe, and should, if you doubt, come to him like Thomas and say, my Lord and my God. You see, even Thomas doubted. We all have our doubts and our fears, but we bring our doubts and fears to him. For I came to Jesus just as I was, weary, wounded, and sad. And I found in him a resting place. And he has made me glad. How many of you are happy this morning to be in God's presence, to be in his house? Because the Bible says, I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Maybe you didn't want to come, but God urged you and God moved you and God calls you to come into his house one more time, and it may be your last time. And so while you are here, give glory to God and thank him for the moment to receive him, body, soul, and divinity in the holy sacrifice of the Mass. Christ, by his incarnation into the world, the Lord has given himself to all men in general, but in the sacrament, he has given himself to each one of us in particular. Do you know that? He has given himself to you in particular. When you come, he comes to you. When you kneel at that altar, the Lord comes to you, and you ought to cry, pass me not, O gentle Savior. Hear my humble cry, while on others thou art calling, do not pass me by. Savior, Savior, hear my humble cry. And when you come, he does hear your cries. Oh, how ardently does Jesus Christ desire you and I to come to him. He asks our souls to come to him in Holy Communion. This desire he expressed at the time of the institution of this sacrament when he said to the apostles in Luke 22:15, with desire to eat the Pasch with you. St. Lawrence Justinian said that these words proceeded from the enamored heart of Jesus Christ. You see, the statue of the Sacred Heart, that heart that burns out of love for us. Christ loves us. Even if we have fallen from grace, even if we have sinned, he invites us to come to him, confess our sins, for he is a loving God that cares for us, that if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. That's how much he loves us. God is not here to judge us and to take us to hell. He said, it is my will that all men be saved and come to the knowledge of truth. That's his love. And from the altar, our Lord extends his hands and he says, come to me, all ye that believe, and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Learn of me. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. And I hear the Lord saying, let not your hearts be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. The Lord is here. This is the voice of the most burning heart. The voice of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. The voice that calls is the kingdom of heaven to those who eat his flesh. You're going to heaven. You know why? Because you're obedient. He that eats this bread shall live forever. Isn't that great? John 6 and 59. Listen, he that eateth this bread shall live forever. Providing that you die in a state of grace. On the other hand, it threatens to deprive us of this grace and of heaven if we neglect Holy Communion. In John 6 and 54, it says, except you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you shall not have life in you. I feel sorry for all of those people who don't come to Mass, who don't come to Communion, who don't know our Lord. These promises and these threats all sprung from a burning desire to come to us in this sacrament. And finally, and why was Jesus Christ so vindictive? Desire that we receive him in Holy Communion. It is because he delights in being united with each of us. But the communion. Jesus is really united to our soul. When you come to this altar, you are being united. You receive grace, and you enter into that intimate relationship with Jesus Christ. He said, if you eat my flesh, you will have life in you. He that eateth and drinketh abides in me. I am him. Isn't that wonderful? Yes. Listen to that again. He that eats my flesh, listen, and drinks my blood, I am, abides in me, and I in him. Thus, after communion, we are, says St. John Chrysostom, after you receive him, Sister Glad, one body, one flesh with Jesus Christ, we enter into that mystery. And so St. Lawrence Justinian exclaims, oh, how wonderful is thy love, O Lord Jesus, who has wished to incorporate us in such a manner with thy body that we should have one heart, one soul, inseparably united with thee. Thus to every soul that receives the Eucharist today, the Lord says what he once said to his beloved Margaret. Behold, my daughter, the close union made between me and you. Love me then, and let us remain forever united in love. Let us nevermore be separated. And if for some reason you fall, get back up and come back to the altar. And say, Lord, have mercy on me. Come into my heart. I believe that you are present, body, soul, and divinity, in the most blessed sacrament of the altar. My sons and daughters, this is intimate union. This is the intimate relationship that Jesus wants with us in this Mass. And that's why I'm here. To draw close to him at this altar, that no matter how many times I have fallen, he invites me, come back, and he that comes to me, I will in no wise cast you out. You want the fruit? You want the antidote? You want the medicine? You want to live? Come to the Holy Mass and receive Jesus Christ, Savior and Lord. Because one day, we will no longer celebrate the Mass. We will join had been slain before the foundations of the world to receive honor and glory and power and dominion both now and forever. And we will cry, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, all hail the power of Jesus' name. Let angels rush straight from us. Bring forth the royal diadem and
expressing the name of the Bishop of the Sacrificial Mission Family for the day of Octave of Corpus Christi.
Oremos. Eternia secula secula,
amen.
Dominus Dominus we give visibility and memoriam of every hour.
boast of the enemy, how the child's person is such a nothing that is seen, everything barely knows how to exist. All three of us, John Evans, Janet Robinson, James Robinson, Mildred Robinson, Gary Lewis, Gary Lewis,
pero mira, se cura. Pero mia secula seculorum.
Thank you.
Mass. Domine nans. Domine nans. Domine nans.
Corpus Christi, Corpus Christi, Corpus Christi, Corpus Christi, Corpus Christi.
Domino,
Alexander, Michigan, is that under mentioned?
Today is the Octave of Corpus Christi. And on this Octave of Corpus Christi, since we were not able to do the processional on this past Thursday because of the air quality, today we will do our processional around the church area and enter back into the sanctuary for the adoration of our Lord and Most Holy Blessed Sacrament. After the benediction, we will all prepare ourselves to go on the
outside as we declare to the world that Christ truly is present in the most blessed sacrament of these altars. Let us kneel for a few moments. Dominus vobis omnis vobis sed nomen Domini benedictus agitorium nostrum Domini benedict ad voles omnia potens Deus Pater ad filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Dominus vobis,
Dominus vobis,
initium sancti regeri secundum Johannes.
Thank you.